In the blizzard of fun, it takes away your joy and happiness. The blizzard. Blizzard, the blizzard. The blizzard. Blizzard, the blizzard. Where there's love, there's life. Joy unspeakable is endless in such home. Oh yeah, a little opening gives the devil an opportunity to roar the storm. Oh, never gave room for such a hole. Such hope come to steal and destroy. Identify red flags in all form before it's too late. Mighty kind company that you keep. My lead you to temptation. Let the Lord God direct your ways, and you'll be victorious.
At the end of the day,
the blizzard, a wind of change, a strategy of the devil to destabilize your peace. Never get stuck in the blizzard of fun. It takes away your joy and happiness. The blizzard. It's endless in such home. Oh yeah, a little opening gives the devil an opportunity to roar the storm. Oh, never gave room for such a hole.
Such hope
that come to steal and destroy. Identify red flags in all form before it's too late. Mighty kind company that you keep. My lead you to temptation. Let the Lord God direct your ways, and you be victorious.
At the end of the day,
the blizzard, a wind of change, a strategy of the devil to destabilize your peace. Never get stuck in the blizzard of fun. It takes away your joy and happiness. The blizzard.
Ifemi, eat your food. The last thing you want to do right now is to starve yourself. May God not allow us to add health issues to what is already on ground.
See, it's just that.
Not until you have eaten, please. Everything will be alright, Ifemi. Let me go and check on Tofumi. Okay? I'll be right back.
My legal temptation.
Let the Lord God direct your ways, and you be victorious.
At the end of the day,
the reason, a wind of change, a strategy of the devil to destabilize your peace. Never get stuck in the blizzard of fun. It takes away your joy and happiness. The blizzard.
Ifemi, you are still awake.
I can't sleep. It's tough for me to sleep.
Yes, she is.
Good.
So, how did it go today?
I put it under lock and key myself. The office is gone. We can't maintain it. Honey, how did we get here? All our hard work gone down the drain just like that.
Ifemi, God is faithful. Let's remember that in all things we should give thanks. It could have been worse, you know.
I know. But where did we get it wrong?
Ifemi, you are the brain behind the whole business. What do you think went wrong?
In retrospect, we shouldn't have taken that loan in the first place. I thought we had a very good plan to service it.
Ifemi, that plan depended so much on man's goodwill. That was the mistake.
A very big one.
And the car?
Sold.
Ah, and I really loved that car.
I did too. At least, we've got rid of the last memento from Zen Holdings.
Yes. So how do we service the rest of the loan now?
I don't know, honestly. I've exhausted all the human capitals I have left.
What if we sold some of our other properties, like the car?
No. That's not an option.
But we need to do something before the ultimatum expires now.
Pastor Rice said the church will do their bit. So let's wait and see how that pans out.
Haven't the church done enough already?
What do we do? At this point, I wouldn't say no to any form of assistance.
It is well. Can we talk to the Father about it before we sleep? Let's thank God for today and hope for a better tomorrow.
Yes, we shall.
Yeah, let us pray.
This is absolutely horrendous. MD.
Yes, sir.
What happened to the debt profile plans you drafted at the last retreat?
Take care, sir. Take care.
Thank you.
The former MD refused to adopt it.
That thief. He was just covering up his tracks. That boy has mismanaged all I struggled to create at Zen Holdings. So, what do you suggest we do now?
Sir, I think we should...
Hey, look, Remy. I don't pay you to think. I pay you to give me actionable plans. Actionable plans! Hey?
Okay, Chief. The first thing we need now is a competent COO. Who will put the house in order and stabilize the company. Then we can build upwards from there.
A new COO?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'll think about it.
All right, sir.
Please, you can take your leave. But make sure you pay the staff salaries on time this month.
Okay, sir.
Good. You see, I don't want any misgivings in case we decide to downsize.
I will do so, sir.
Thank you.
All right, sir. Goodbye, sir. Take care.
Oh, God.
My MD.
Oh, God, Charlie.
My MD.
Oh, God, Charlie. Have you been?
My guy, they're fine. No.
Oh, my God.
You don't even see your brake light.
Oh, God, Charlie, it's not like that, eh? I would have popped in from time to time, but the circumstances that caused my exit wouldn't allow it now.
Ogami, I understand perfectly. Only that everybody, they miss you.
Hey, yeah. Miss if I didn't miss everybody now. How are you and the family?
Family, they, oh my God. As you can see, I still full grand brekete. Oh, soldier, never die.
I see you, Oga Charlie. I see you. Ah, how about the other people at the company, Mr. Telanko?
Mr. Telanko, I hear you mentioned just like that. As you come out, you don't mismanage the company. Chifalaki don't sack him. Now, Madam Remy be the MD now.
Oh, that's good. Remy is very competent.
That woman no get problem, Jerry. Mm-hmm. But the load is too much on her. See, be Corolla when they don't put the load where they're supposed to give trailer.
Oga Charlie, what do you mean?
Oga, no be me tell you. It be like, see, Zen don't enter debt, serious debt.
Really?
In fact, since I've been at Zen, we were owed 2 months salary until recently.
Wow, that's not normal.
In fact, as soon as you and Mother had they come out, now everything done the ghost boy.
It is well.
It is well, my Oga. What do you come do here?
Well, I came to get groceries from the supermarket around there. I'm waiting for a cab anyways.
Grocery? Okay, what can be your car?
It's unavailable at the moment. This is one of the company's cars.
Yes, so at the carry and go mechanic side.
Okay. All right. Okay, Charlie.
Make I carry you.
No. Don't worry. I'll be very fine. Eh? Honestly, I'll be fine.
It's okay.
Thank you.
My all MD. Right.
Okay, Charlie.
My MD.
Take care of yourself and your family.
All right.
Bye bye. All right. Yeah. Bye bye.
Hello, Dad.
Uche, how are you?
I'm fine, Daddy. How are you feeling today?
I don't even know. I've seen better days.
I'm sorry, sir. I spoke with Mommy and she has agreed that we should bring you over here.
Look, I'm fine. I'm doing just fine.
Daddy, we both know you're not fine.
Uche, have you gone through the documents I sent you?
I have, sir.
Good. You can see how that boy almost ruined all I struggled to build from the scratch. Eh?
It's terrible and appalling. What can we do to save Zen, sir?
I was hoping you would give us the solution.
Okay. Have you spoken with IJ?
IJ does not have a solution yet. She's as appalled as I am. We are in a very dire situation that needs urgent fixing. And I was hoping you'd be able to bail us out.
Okay. First, I think the company needs a new chief operating officer. You've not had one since IJ left.
Yes. I have that in mind too. But it's a position we cannot give to a Greyhorn or a total stranger to Zen Holdings. Do you have anyone in mind?
Right now, the only capable person that comes to mind is one you might not like.
And who could that be?
Dad, never mind.
No, please, Uche. Don't do that to me. You see, I'm a sick man, not a dying man.
Femi Gomez would be a perfect fit. The records show that he performed excellently as MD before what happened. So if he has done it before, he definitely can do it again. Hello, Dad. Are you there?
Femi Gomez.
Hmm. Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Mr. Femi. I am Jude Ofili, and this is Chuka Benton. We are from the FS Bank.
Oh, FSB. How may I help you?
We are here because we noticed you've not been servicing your loan for quite a while now. Several calls and emails to you were not returned, so we decided to come check on you.
Oh, that. I had already explained my company situation to my account officer.
In case you are not aware, your account officer was recently fired for enabling bad loans.
Oh.
Yes, so we are here to remind you that your loan is due next month and you have defaulted for 3 months. Bear in mind, a failure to pay up the loan can lead to...
I know. Please, I'm going to pay up.
Okay, and when, if I may ask you?
Honey, I'm coming. You're already missing daddy, right? I'm coming. Please, just give me to the end of the month.
Okay. For the sake of your family, I hope you pay up.
Thank you. May I see you off?
Sure.
Let's walk now.
This is serious. How come you never mentioned to me that you took a loan from FSB?
I'm sorry. I used that loan to service the other one.
Oh my God. This is getting critical. What do we do now?
I don't even know. See, I used this house as a collateral.
You did what? You did what? Hey, this is unbelievable.
Oh, it's a foreign number. Who could be calling me at this time of the day? I'm not picking this.
Please answer your call. You never can tell.
Hello?
Hello, Mr. Femi Gomez. This is Uchena Alaki on the line. Chief Robert Alaki's son and Aija's younger brother. So that is why I've been making the case for you to come back to Zeno Events. I still believe you are the man to successfully bring the company out of this mess. So I wanted to get your approval personally before the company makes a formal approach. What do you say?
You want me back?
Yes. Not as the MD, but now as the COO.
Would you stop? Is this a prank?
If you knew me well, you'd have known I don't have time for such frivolities. I am a dead serious man.
And the former CEO?
IJ's fine with it. Her report about you was very favorable. I think this is a win-win situation for both of us. Think about it. Zen is also like your family. You're more or less a part of the Alaki dynasty now.
No.
Excuse me?
I'm not interested.
Come on, Femi. I understand your reservations, but it's perfectly fine. I assure you, the chief favors you still.
I really appreciate your kind words and assurance, but I really can't do it. I already moved on from Zen. I have my own business now.
I understand your position. Still, I'll advise that you give it a good thought.
I assure you that there will be no need for that. Thank you very much for your consideration. Uche, I'm honored.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
So who was that?
Uche Nak Alake, Chief Robert's son.
IJ's younger brother. What does he want?
Zen Holdings is in crisis. So they want me to return as their new CEO.
Okay, so what's the problem?
I'm not going.
You're joking, right?
What do you mean?
With all the debts and losses that we are grappling with, Zen wants you back and you say you don't want to go? Can't you see this is the Lord answering our prayers?
My dear, some mammoth problems camouflage themselves as enormous blessings. Don't be deceived.
I'm not deceived. Were you not the one that said you wouldn't reject any form of help at this point in time?
Precious, that company belongs in my past. It's dead to me.
Don't be blinded by sentiments, Ifemi. Don't call unclean what God has made clean. If anyone should have reservations about your going back to Zen, it should be me. But I know better, and you should too.
Woman.
Man.
Well, I've heard you, but I'm not convinced.
So, what do you want to do now?
Honestly, sir, we don't even know. We have done all we can.
That's serious. When is the deadline?
Sir, we have to the end of next month to pay up, or we forfeit our house.
That means you have to generate and pay back about 20 million naira between now and then?
Yes, sir.
What about your guarantor?
Well, my guarantor has his own financial troubles as well, and I don't want to add more to his distress.
So what manner of trouble is he in?
He defaulted in paying back his own loan to another bank, and his company was taken over by Amcom until he's able to pay back what he owes.
It's a pity. I do tell people that loans should be the last resort for a startup business. Thank God, because we have an ultimate guarantor in heaven who does not disappoint. I'm going to speak with the leadership of the church, and we'll look at what we can do. I can't promise any particular amount, but we will definitely do something.
Wow. After all you've done, thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank God. That is the essence of our fellowship. Being there for one another in our hour of need. Besides, you and your wife have been so committed to the Lord's work over the years. We will not abandon you now. Impossible.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank God.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank God. Sister Precious.
Sir?
I've been curious to know why you have been so quiet. Is it because of the same issue?
Yes, sir, but there is more.
Yes, sir. Apparently, sir, we would like to take our leave now. Thank you very much.
Hey, brother Femi, where are you rushing to? Your wife obviously has something she wants to get off her chest. So please sit down, brother. My sister, speak.
Thank you, sir. The thing is, a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity recently came up for us, sir. But my husband is refusing to take it.
What kind of opportunity is that?
Actually, sir, it's Zen Holdings. Their company is in deep crisis. So they want me back in the company as the chief operation officer.
Okay, that's a promotion from your former position, isn't it?
Yes, sir. They believe I can help engineer a turnaround in the company's fortune.
Okay. And then you don't want to take it, right?
For obvious reasons, sir.
Is IJ still there?
No, sir. But our father owns the company and he's like, I'm going back to my vomit.
Sister Precious.
Sir?
Are you convinced he should take it?
Yes, sir.
Is it because you are desperate?
Not at all, sir. I see it as God's answer to our prayers. Moses ran away from Egypt after committing a crime, but that did not stop God from using him again to save the Israelites when it was time.
So, have you prayed about it?
That's why I brought it up, sir. Since my husband and I are not on the same page, I was hoping you would help us see God's face on the matter, sir.
I am not a prayer contractor, Sister Precious. As your pastor, my duty is to teach and guide you on how to grow and be mature Christians. This matter is personal. You both have to seek God's face on your own. And then please, whatever the Lord is leading you to do, ensure that it is in conformity with His word. I can join you in prayers from here.
All right, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
I apologize if any offense has been caused.
No. I am not offended. Can we pray together?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let's pray. The blizzard, in Jesus' name. Amen. Father, thank you for your son and your...
Never get stuck in the blizzard of fun. It takes away your joy and happiness. The
blizzard. Take care, sir.
Blizzard, the blizzard.
Thank you.
The blizzard.
Well done.
The blizzard.
This is slightly better.
Thank you, sir.
I hope you can keep the ship steady, pending when the sailor arrives.
I will try my best, sir.
What other choice do we have?
If I may ask, sir, what about the CEO position?
The CEO. I'm still working on it. Expect a briefing very soon.
Oh, okay, sir. Okay, sir. Take care, sir. May I take my leave now?
Of course. Thanks for coming at such a short notice.
All right, sir.
By the way, how are your husband and girl?
They are fine, sir.
Good. Yes, sir. Okay, take care.
All right, sir.
This girl, she's always in a hurry.
About time already.
Ademi, I'm so sorry. I had to be in Chief's place for a briefing.
You went to Chief's house? Yeah. What's wrong with meeting at the office?
The man is not well. I already told you this.
Whatever. I need to eat dinner before 7. This is 6:30.
I'll get right to it. Come here.
Oh. Good evening, ma.
Oh, Petra, how are you? How was school today?
School was fine.
And where is your sister?
I don't know.
Ah. What do you mean you don't know?
I've not seen her since we closed from school.
Really? Ademi, are you aware of this?
I was actually going to talk about it after dinner. Ha. That girl is growing wings.
After dinner?
Shouldn't we go and search for her or call the police?
No, mommy. There is no need. She'll come home tonight, you'll see.
I see. What do you know that you are not telling me?
I only know that she goes away for a long time, only to return late at night.
Hmm? Since when?
She will meet me in this house when she comes.
Ha! Huh.
Ifemi, what's the matter?
Honestly, I'm not happy with you.
Why? Is it because of the Zen matter?
What you did at Pastor's right office was totally wrong. Please, don't let it repeat itself.
Ifemi, I thought we already discussed this on our way back from Pastor's office. I had to do this for our sake.
See, I understand why you did it. But we're supposed to agree on matters like this before we spill them out. I mean, didn't you see how clueless we appeared in front of him? Gosh, I can't even get that scene off my head.
I really don't see any problem with that. Besides, I already told you Pastor Wright will hear of this.
And did I approve of you telling him?
Come on, Ifemi. You were dragging your feet. And we needed to make a decision fast.
Look, I'm not interested in going back to Zen Holdings.
Eh? Okay, oh, let me show you something. That's tofu mistution. It's almost due. We are running out of groceries. The ones you bought the last time is almost exhausted. The FSB loan is not the only thing you should be worried about. Oh. We need a sustainable income in this family. And I've been trying to get a job without any success. You are the only one with an opening. Please don't throw this one away because of your ego.
This is not about my ego. I fell once, and I don't want to fall again. Will the staff still want me?
Ifemi, look into my eyes. Have I ever lied to you before? I believe this opening is from God. Who cares what anybody thinks?
Woman, you can be very persistent.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, let's pray about it.
Finally.
Finally what? I've not agreed now. Let's pray.
Let's pray.
Heavenly Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you because
so, Dad, that's the situation right now.
IJ, what do you think?
Dad, it is very understandable if he says he can't do it. I wouldn't do it if it was me. Although, Femi is one person that I know that can deliver and be loyal. I suggest that we look at other alternatives, since he appears not to be interested.
We may have to, because time is really not on our side.
So what other options do we have?
What of the MD of FSB?
Kolyosho? No. That man will spend all the money we have left on booze and women.
What about Mr. Nnamdi of Crossworks?
Nnamdi? He is a close associate of Chief Rawlings, my competitor. The next thing you know, they'll be asking for a merger or a takeover. Look, we have to be discreet about our problems. Capital, no.
IJ, any ideas?
None for now.
For Laomi, I know you are never clueless. So, don't play dumb now.
Honestly, Dad, I have no idea. I have been out of the game for a while.
This is serious. What do we do now? IJ, can you speak with Femi?
Uche, seriously, did you just ask me that?
Never mind. I'm sorry.
Here is what will happen. Let us give Femi Gomez some time to think about it.
Let's give him an ultimatum in case he changes his mind. By the end of this week, he should notify us of his final decision.
All right, Daddy. A name just popped in my head now. What about GD Gaspar, the former COO of Nico Investment? He's probably the best in the business and he's available. His CV is unmatched.
I remember GD. That's a big one. Can we afford him?
We can generate an agreement that works for both parties.
Can he be trusted?
He should. He has had no known affiliation since he left Nico.
I see. Jide is quite good and disciplined.
All right, sir. Sis, what do you think?
Fine by me. I'm okay with whatever decision works for Zen.
Contact him immediately.
But Dad, isn't it too late in the night for such a call?
Do it tonight. A lot of companies want Jide on their team, so he may no longer be available by tomorrow morning.
Find myself in this kind of a situation. I can't go on like this. I can't. Lord, please help me. What should I do now? Should I go or should I not go?
Got off the phone with Jide. He sounded a bit of hard by initially, but sounded interested by the end of our conversation. He said he would give a definite answer after he sees a formal offering. You were right, Dad. Apparently, some of our competitors have been courting him.
Are you sure this boy won't be a pain in the neck?
For our sakes, I hope he won't be, sir.
All right. I will ask the office to prepare a formal document tomorrow.
All right, sir.
Good.
Psalm 66. Verse 17. I cried to him with my mouth, and he was extolled with my tongue. If I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. But certainly, God has heard me. He has attended to the voice of my prayer. Blessed be God who has not turned away my prayer, nor his mercy from me. Thank you, Jesus. I think I know what to do now. Thank you, Lord.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Come on, Ifemi. You can do this. God will give you the right utterance.
Amen.
Hello?
Hello, Uche. It's me, Femi Gomez.
Hello, Femi. I know it's you. Today's deadline. Have you made up your mind?
Maybe. Please, first I need an audience with the CEO.
Oh, give me a minute, I'll get back to you.
Hello?
Hello, Femi. Tomorrow, 10 a.m. at the house. Don't be late.
Really? Thank you very much. All right. Tomorrow.
Okay.
10 a.m. Jesus.
Where are you coming from?
Good evening, sir. I'm coming from Bimbo's house.
Which Bimbo?
My friend Bimbo.
The one who said she saw you last during the break time, or which one?
Ma?
Answer me, young woman.
You are shouting.
You will not talk to your mother in that tone. I will not allow it. What has come over you? Your sister has been home since 4 p.m. and you are just returning now. Where have you been?
I...
Speak up before I pounce on you.
I went to a friend's birthday party. I knew if I had come first, you wouldn't allow me go. So...
Whose birthday was it?
My classmate, Diva.
Hmm?
Diva. What kind of a person bears Diva as her name?
It's her nickname. Her name is Dia Kolama.
Mm.
Yes, ma'am.
Look at the time, Patricia. 10 p.m. And that is an ungodly hour for a teenager to just be returning home from school. Are you now moving about with gangs in your school?
Ah, no. God forbid. No.
Patricia. I worked overtime at the office today. I'm very tired and sleepy, yet my eyes have not tasted sleep just because you are yet to be back. I was going to call the police if not for your sister who assured me that you will soon be back. Yet, what do you do? You come home this late and you still have the effrontery to tell me that I'm shouting? Ah! Is that how we brought you up? I'm sure we did better than that. Ah, I'm so disappointed in you right now.
I'm sorry, Ma. It won't happen again.
Oh, that was what you said the last time. And the last time before the last.
I promise it won't.
There is no need to give assurances. You are grounded. Till further notice.
The blizzard, a wind of change.
Daddy has spoken. Go to bed now. You have an early day of work tomorrow.
Never get stuck.
Good night.
In the blizzard of fun. It takes away your joy and happiness. The blizzard. Blizzard. The blizzard. The blizzard. Blizzard. The blizzard.
You fear me. You look so handsome.
Are you sure?
I'm too sure. I really miss seeing you like this, you know.
Ifemi, thank you. But apparently, I'm nervous though. I don't know what to expect.
God has gone ahead of you, Ifemi. You have absolutely nothing to fear. Didn't you say Uche told you that Chief Alake still favors you?
But what about the IJ factor?
Isn't that in the past? She's happily married in the UK. I'm here with you. I don't think there's anything to worry about again.
I think you're right. Maybe I'm just worried about I'm going to be received back at the office. That is if Chief accepts my deal.
You fear me? Mm-hmm. Ah, one step at a time. Please stop worrying and get going. You don't want to be late, do you?
Apparently, I think I should go now. Hmm?
All right. See you I'll later. Be praying for you.
All right, then. Yeah, bye-bye.
Bye.
Be the first time. I thought you'd be man enough to own up to your feelings and your desires. As the MD of Zen Holdings, take hold of that which you desire for once. Take me, my family. I'm all yours.
Good afternoon, sir.
Ah, Femi Gomez himself. How are you doing, my boy?
I'm very fine, sir. Thank you, sir.
Good. I'm so happy to see you. Please have your seat.
Thank you, sir.
So what should the maid bring for you?
Oh, I'm fine, sir. There's no need.
Are you sure?
I'm very sure, sir.
Okay, that's okay. Uche said you asked for an audience with me.
Yes, I did.
Okay. I am here. You are here. Please go ahead.
Thank you, sir, for agreeing to see me. You did not have to.
Look, you come off it, Femi. Because you had a fling with my daughter? Look, I am not that petty. Besides, through you, I now have a grandson. Yeah? In fact, in my eyes now.
Sorry, sir.
Thank you. I see you as a bona fide member of my family.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you. So, now that that is out of the way, what's your decision on the position of the COO? Because you could, I don't have all the time in this world to fill that position.
About that, sir, of a truth, I have a business I've been running since I left Zen Holding. And that is why I can't return as a full staff. However, I haven't heard about the precarious situation of the company. I feel I could offer my services in the consultancy capacity to help return the company to its glory days.
Femi Gomez, you want to consult for us? You're a very funny man. Do you know the number of people that are pushing for this job? Do you know? And do you know that I can pay you far more than you are earning from your business?
I know, sir. But that's the only condition on top which I can return.
All right, all right. That's okay. Look, give it whatever name you wish. In my eyes, you are returning as the COO of Zen Holdings. And you'll be expected to perform all the responsibilities attached to it.
Sir?
So, Femi, when are you resuming?
Father Lord, I pray for favor for my husband as he goes. Father Lord, you prosper him in the name of Jesus. You work let all together for his will in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, you help him, Lord, in the name of Jesus. You give him the right utterance in the name of Jesus. You make all things work together for our good in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jehovah. Thank you, Lord. Exalt your holy name. Thank you, Father.
Hello? Ifemi, how far?
It's a deal.
You got the job?
Yeah, we got the job.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
God is faithful. Congratulations, Ifemi. Where are you now?
I just left his house. I didn't leave the place empty-handed. So I want to stop at the mall to get a few things.
Please, Oreo, I need to get the full gist. And we need to thank God together.
I will soon be there.
Okay. Have you informed Pastor Wright?
No, let me do that now.
Okay. See you soon. Bye. Oh, thank God. I'm so excited. Oh, God is faithful. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank
you. Wow. This is good news. Congratulations, my brother.
Thank you so much, sir.
May this new position bring you joy and have no sorrow.
Amen.
You see, the wisdom you used could have only come from heaven. That was why I asked you to seek the Lord's face yourself. Just as I didn't choose your life partner for you, I can only guide you in God's way. I am glad you heard and have heeded to the divine leading yourself.
Thank you very much for all you do for us, sir.
It is my job to do my Heavenly Father's bidding. I am so happy for you. Is your wife there?
No, I'm still on my way home.
All right. Please, extend my warmest greetings to her. All right now, remain blessed, my brother.
Brother Femi, right?
Yes, so he has been recalled to his former place of work and promoted to COO.
Wow, that's lovely. But why return after all that has happened?
Ah, dear, that is in the past now.
How sure are we that this is not a bait from that woman?
I don't think so. She has relocated to meet her husband in the UK, remember? The company is in crisis, and Brother Femi was specifically requested for by Chief Alake himself. I asked them to pray about it, and they told me that the Lord is leading them to take the offer.
That is good then.
Yes, yes. I believe now that he's matured enough to face whatever challenges he finds there.
I believe so too. This is a wonderful turnaround for them.
Yes, so.
Hallelujah.
It's here, ma.
Thank you.
You're welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Yes.
You are welcome.
Wow.
thank you.
You're welcome. Ogachan.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Wow.
Yeah.
My, oh my.
Father, I thank you. Thank you for this opportunity again. Thank you for this that you have done.
Thank you.
Thank you for today.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you because it's a day that you have made.
Thank you, Lord.
We rejoice and we are glad in it.
Amen.
Take charge, O God.
Amen.
In Jesus' name I've prayed.
Amen.
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 Wow.
congratulations once again, COO.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
I'm really happy for you.
I should say thank you. And I see that you have not stopped being nice.
It's just who I am.
Please, don't stop.
Okay.
The world is going to be a better place with a lot more nice people like you.
The world is what it is.
Yeah. Please, bring me the reports of the last quarter.
Okay.
And the one before.
Okay.
Let's get to work.
All right.
Shall we?
All right, I'll be back.
Wow. Really, this is preposterous. And you expect me to sign this? How long has this been happening?
About 3 years now, sir.
And you do not report it?
Sir, I don't want to lose my job.
I'm sure you know that this thing you're doing is very wrong. Very wrong!
I know, sir. But anytime I try not to do her bidding, she rains insults on my person and threatens me.
I see. You can go. Thanks for making me aware.
Okay, sir. Sir, I'm not trying to implicate her or anything.
I understand, Dexter.
I really love my job. I don't have any fallback plan.
Dexter, I understand. You have nothing to worry about. I'll take it all from here.
All right, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, too. Good morning, sir.
CEO, this is a surprise. I hope all is well.
I'm here so that all will be well, sir.
What happened? Please sit down.
Thank you very much, sir. Sir, as part of the auditing process we are currently undertaking, I asked the accountant for a report. And then, of course, he submitted. And then he brought me also a payment voucher to sign. I noticed some similar unsolicited payment in his report. And so I asked him for more details. He informed me that Ijeoma, the former CEO, has been collecting money from the company's account for personal upkeep on a frequent basis.
What? Impossible. Why would Ijeoma do such a thing?
I honestly do not know, sir.
Okay. Let me speak with her right away. Thank you.
Hello, Daddy.
Folahanmi Ijeoma. How are you?
I'm fine, sir. This
you're calling me out of the blues. Is everything all right?
I really hope everything is all right. Now, Ijeoma, is it true that you have been collecting unsolicited amounts from the company's account for personal use? It is true, right?
I use the money for Marcus' upkeep, not for myself.
And so what? Ijeoma, are you broke?
No, Dad. I only request for the money whenever there is a special event like his birthday or any other urgent need that may require traveling.
Ijeoma, you of all people should know that it's against company policy. Eh? You have more than enough to take care of yourself. Please stop doing this. We are already grappling with enough debt. Austerity is of utmost importance. Eh?
I'm sorry, Dad, but I didn't want to disturb your Gabriel whenever he has such needs.
What about the father of the boy?
There's no need to disturb him. I am self-sufficient.
I see. Anyway, please stop collecting money from the company's account. There is a new COO in place and he wouldn't sign off such requests. Look, if you need anything, just ask me. I will make sure that you and Marcus are well taken care of.
All right, Dad. Thank you.
Thank you, my daughter. Self-sufficient. Eh? This girl wouldn't just stop amazing me. Well, I believe that is settled now.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Good.
I will take my leave now, sir.
Please, just a minute before you go. I would have called you later in the day, but it's good that you are here. I think I should just go ahead and discuss this matter with you. You'll be traveling out of the country next week.
Sorry, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Traveling?
Yes. You see, Uche linked up with some angel investors in the UK and he has arranged a meeting for next week. So, you have to travel out of the country in the next few days. I hope your passport is still intact.
It still is, sir.
You will leave for London where you will link up with Uche. I'm sure Uche will call to brief you before the weekends.
All right, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, CEO. Please keep doing well. Thank you.
Welcome, Daddy.
How are you, Pat?
I'm fine, sir.
How are you feeling now?
I feel a little better.
Okay.
Your friends asked after you. One of them asked me to give you a note.
Thank you, Petra.
Have you eaten?
Yes, sir.
Taking your drugs?
Yes, sir.
All right. I need to head back to the side now. Petra.
Sir.
Please take good care of your sister. I'll see you guys later.
Bye, Daddy.
Okay, bye.
You really think you can fool me, Pat?
What do you mean?
Where exactly is paining you?
Everywhere.
Everywhere. Okay. Dear Patricia, you are the love of me.
Don't you dare read my letter.
I knew it. You are not sick. Just wanted to escape the punishment you were meant to serve with Diva.
And so?
Pat, you really need to take things easy. You can't keep getting in trouble. It's not good for anyone.
It's my life and I can live it anyhow I want.
Do you care about how your life affects
I
your
I don't.
God will help you.
Any this from school?
A wind of change, a strategy of the devil to destabilize your peace. Never get stuck in the blizzard of fun.
My sister, I tell you, God has been faithful. I mean, I was already scared of what those people would do to us. I hope never to see those men again, because it's only strong people that should get loans from the bank. It's not funny at all. Okay, no problem. God is on the throne. It is well. Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye.
Okay.
Come in, the gate is opened.
Good morning, madam.
Good morning.
We are from FSB.
I know. What do you want?
Well, nothing much. We are just here to remind you that the final deadline for your payment expires in 2 weeks.
And you had to come all the way down here to tell us that.
Your husband has actually refused to respond or acknowledge our mails and messages.
All right, we'll get back to you soon.
If I may ask, when?
I said soon.
I hope you know that this house is your collateral.
Hey, what's with the emphasis? It's like you people don't know who my husband is. You wait and see. He would have paid all the money by the deadline and even add extra on top.
I pray so. I will take her leave now.
Do that.
Thank you.
They should just shut my gate. Okay?
Everything is going to be fine. I'll be back before the deadline.
But don't you have some money now?
I don't, but by the time I return from this trip, I should have something substantial. If I pay them a little, that should buy us some money.
Okay.
Honey.
Yes?
Is there any other thing?
Will I get the part of the team in the UK?
No. Why?
Nothing, no. I just want to know if you guys will be seeing each other.
I don't think I will even have the time to. Besides, she even stays far away from London. See, babe, there's nothing to worry about. Nothing.
Okay, I'll just come back with plenty pounds.
I've seen the big pounds on the street of London. Very funny.
Do you have another house that we live in if the bank takes this one from us?
No.
Exactly why I said you should come back with plenty pounds. God will help you.
God will help us.
I just wish I could do more in Femi.
Babe, after selling almost all your jewelries, don't push yourself too hard.
Okay.
I know that God is going to make a way. And I'm very sure.
God will make our way where there seems to be no way. He walks in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for us. He will be our guide.
Yes.
This is delicious. It's actually the best meal I've eaten since I traveled.
Really?
Honestly, all I could eat was just vegetables and bread. I couldn't wait to come back to you, my baby.
I'm glad that you're back. I'm so sorry that the reception was not as warm as it was supposed to be.
My dear.
Yes.
All will be well, I'm sure.
How come you are so sure?
I just know it.
I really thought our money problems would go immediately you resumed as Zen Holdings. But this thorn has refused to go away.
See, Ifemi, the god of our journey knows more than we do. This is not the time for us to fret or panic. See, we'll put our trust in the Lord and not lean on our own understanding.
You sound like you know something I don't.
Maybe I do.
What?
Well, I met this man of God on the plane. He was sitting next to me when I was returning back to the country. We got talking and then he gave me some words of knowledge that, you know, shook me to my marrows. One would have thought that we've known ourselves from way back. He prophesied specifically to me that God is going to turn my sorrow and that of my family into joy. To quote him, he said, God will wipe away your tears.
Amen.
He even gave me his complimentary card.
Oh.
As he spoke, it was as if the heavens opened and God was talking to me directly. In fact, my spirit was moved in an unusual way.
That's great. I pray his prophecy comes to pass very soon.
Well, let's see what God will do. Babe, I feel sleepy already.
Okay, no problem.
Thank you.
Patricia, come on, wake up!
Good afternoon, ma. So, good morning.
Same to you. Do you know what time it is now? This is 10:30 a.m. and you are still in bed on a Saturday morning. Did you go for vigil or walk overnight? Your sister has been the only one working since morning. Get up and do your chores.
Mommy, you want me to walk? You know I just finished taking my medications.
And so what? Are you still sick?
No.
Get up and get to work. Huh? See how untidy your section is. Have you forgotten all that I taught you about being a proper lady? Even God does not like uncleanliness. Come on, come back and take this.
So in the next 7 years, I'm projecting that our annual turnover should be in excess of 100 million naira. That's if we are able to clean up this mess quickly. MD. MD.
Yes, what?
Are you okay?
Yes, you were talking about projections for the next 7 years.
Who among men know the thought of a man except the man's spirit within him? I could as well assume that you're all right and continue with my presentation, but I'm not wired that way. My job will only be effective if my team players are in good working condition. It's obvious that you're distracted. Talk to me.
There's no need to you. There's nothing happening that should bother you.
Are you sure?
I'm fine.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Hello, sir. I'm fine, sir. When? Now? Okay. I'm on my way, sir. MD.
Yeah.
Please mind the office.
Okay.
Chief Alaki wants me in his house immediately.
Oh, all right.
Please.
Okay.
Oga Charlie, get the car ready. We're going out. Good afternoon, sir.
Ha, Femi.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You're a genius. I always knew you've got it in you.
What happened, sir?
Please sit down. Sit down.
Thank you, sir.
Look, I got an email from the UK angel investors this afternoon. They were very impressed by your presentations. So they are in.
Chief, you mean they are going to invest $500,000 in Zen Holdings?
Exactly. Look, we are back and better.
Wow. This is beautiful news, sir.
You did it, my son.
Not at all, sir. God did it. I was just a vessel used.
Look, Femi, I am very proud of you. Zen Holdings is indebted to you. That's why I'm about to hand over to you what it's long overdue.
Sorry, sir. Sorry, sir. What is it, sir?
Thank you. Do you know there is a special benefit package for Zen veterans? For those who have served this company meritoriously for over 10 years, and those who have attained executive position,
You see, they are entitled to a luxury apartment in one of the choicest estates in town.
Wow. I mean...
So, as the brilliant COO of Zen Holdings, you see, your house should showcase the exalted office you occupy and the quality of your brain. So, I will be handing over to you a key to one of the luxury flats in Zen Estate.
Wow! This is you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Congratulations once again.
Thank you, sir.
You see, Femi, all my life, I've been searching for this holy grail that all successful men find it difficult, if not impossible, to locate a worthy successor. But you are my holy grail, boy. I think my soul can now rest in peace.
Chief. Take care, sir. Take care, sir.
Thank you.
Chief, I mean, why don't you tell your children to take you abroad for proper treatment?
You see, I don't think there is any reason whatsoever to waste scarce resources on an irreversible condition like this. Look, I know my fate and I am resigned to it.
Please, sir, I don't...
That's okay, my boy. Please, just go back to your work and keep my business afloat. You see, that is the only thing about me that should be of concern to you.
Right, sir. Take care, sir. Take care, sir.
Thank you.
Chief, Jesus loves you. The scripture says, now therefore there is no condemnation against him who is in Christ Jesus. If you are in Christ Jesus, there is no condemnation, sir. Why not surrender your life unto him? He loves you, sir. I'm sorry, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
He has done for me. He has done for me what my father cannot do. He has done for us.
God is so wonderful.
Thank you, Jesus.
To think that we just paid half of our loan with FSB.
Wow.
Now this. This God is too much.
God is indeed wonderful. Did you remember what I told you the prophet told me?
Which prophet?
The man of God on the plane.
Oh, I remember. But you didn't tell me he's an ordained prophet now.
He is. It happened just like he said it would.
That man is really a man of God.
I tell
What's
you.
His name again?
Prophet God's power.
Ah.
I tell you.
Whoa, a powerful prophet with such a powerful name.
See, just look at us. From almost losing our only house to owning two homes. Indeed, double honor lies where there has been disgrace for a child of God.
Yes, so have you informed Pastor Wright?
Oh, shoot. Oh, no, but I'll call him first thing tomorrow morning.
And the prophet?
The same.
Maybe you should send a message to him just to encourage him. And don't you think we should go and see him in person?
Really?
Yes, such a man of God should be thanked in person and in kind.
You're right.
And we should also invite him to come and dedicate the new house. Don't you think so?
Shouldn't that be the responsibility of Pastor Wright?
Oh, Pastor Wright. Well, I understand why he needs to be there. But you know, this prophet's case is very unique. You know, he was the one that prophesied this into existence.
Honey, let's not get ourselves worked up over this, eh? Okay. We'll revisit it later. I've been thinking of something.
What's that?
Well, as the CEO, I wield a lot of power at Zen Holdings. I'm thinking maybe I could sign off some amount from the company's account to pay off the rest of our loan. Just to borrow, and I'll return gradually. What do you think?
Ah, no. Ifemi, please, you're a man of integrity, and you shouldn't do anything that would tarnish your image. Was it not because the company was in crisis that they hired you in the first place? Taking from Zen's purse is like dipping your hand into a cesspit. Ifemi, you have to be a solution in that place. Don't be a problem to them.
You are very correct. Very correct. Thank you for the wise counsel.
You're welcome.
But then, let's celebrate what we have now.
Okay.
Let me switch off my phone. Oh, no.
So, what are we using to celebrate it?
Baby!
Let's go.
Good morning. Wait. What's happening? Why is everybody wearing a long face? What's happening? Oga Charlie, is the MD around? Remy, what's going on? Can someone talk to me now?
Are you not aware?
Aware of what?
Have you checked your phone this morning?
No, it has been switched off since yesterday.
Please switch it on.
No, no, no. When did this happen? How?
It happened last night.
Hello? Yes. What? Oh my God. How come? Was he sick?
He had been sick for quite some time now. I don't even know how to feel. I was just beginning to really get to know the man.
That's very sad and unfortunate. I'm so sorry, my love.
It is the family I feel so sorry for. A giant has fallen. Chief Robert Alake's shoe is very big. He was a father figure and mentor to many.
I can imagine. Was he saved?
I wouldn't know. I can't say for sure.
It is well. To think he just promised us a house yesterday.
That is irrelevant right now, Presh.
I understand. Our testimony won't be turned into a false dawn in Jesus' name. The devil is a liar.
Indeed he is.
I hope you're all right.
Still trying to gather my thoughts.
So when are you going to their house?
As soon as I drop this call.
Is there anything I can do?
No. No need, I'll be fine.
Stay strong, my love. You have Chief's company to run. That's his legacy. The Lord will see you through in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All the best. I'll check on you later.
Thank you very much. We'll talk later.
Bye, love.
How are you?
Yes, sir.
I'm here with some top executives from Zen Holdings.
Okay.
Is mommy around?
Yes. Please come, sir.
Thank you. Yes. Good morning, Ma.
How I see you?
I'm very fine, Ma. I'm sorry about what up.
It is because of words like this that I'm staying away from the crowd. More than half of those people did not really care when he was sick. Now that he's gone, they all troop out like we are giving handouts. I asked you to come in because I know you are not like any of them. Please excuse me. Please sit.
Yes.
Thank you.
Femi.
Ma?
Please come with me.
I should come with you.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much, Ma. So, how have you been with old enough?
Robert already knew what was coming. I knew it as well. Just that it's a matter of when, not if. That's why he refused to be flown abroad for treatment. The rich man's disease, they call it. But what they did not know is that it will reach also cry. Good health is the greatest wealth.
You are very right, Ma. Very right.
I'm sorry I'm talking too much.
No, not at all. It's fine, Ma. Fine.
What shall I offer you? A drink? Water or what?
I'm fine, Ma.
Are you sure?
Yes, I am, Ma.
This bereaved woman
He's asking for what to offer me. This doesn't make sense.
Robert liked you. I hope you knew that.
Yes, ma, I know, ma.
He was really impressed by you. And he wished you were the man that would resuscitate Zen's fortunes. You and no one else. In fact, if not that you were already married, he wished you were the one that married IG. He liked you that much.
Ma, I hope you've been able to speak with IJ and Uche.
Yes, we have been speaking frequently since yesterday.
Okay.
Are you leaving already?
Not at all, ma. I would like to pray with you.
All right, Femi.
Father, in the name of Jesus, the giver of life, the creator of heaven and earth, and everything therein, we worship and we bless your name. For you are the Almighty God, the God who walk in the midst of the seven golden lampstand, the God who holds the seven stars by his right hand. Father, I say, be thou exalted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, I commit Mrs. Dame Alake unto your care. I ask that your mighty hand will sustain her.
Amen.
That in this trying time, your Holy Spirit will be available to comfort her.
Amen.
Pour succor to our wound in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you because you have answered our prayers. For in Jesus' mighty name I have prayed.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Femi.
Mommy, God will comfort you and your family in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Femi.
And I will be coming around to check on you from time to time.
Thank you, Femi.
It is well.
Thank you so much. There's something I would like to give you. That's why I wanted you here alone. Please just hold on for me.
What could happen?
Yeah, Femi. I have this. He told me about the house he promised you.
He did?
Yes. There's hardly any big decision he wants to take that I don't know about.
Wow.
He could not process it, but he gave a final instruction before he gave up the ghost. Have you ever been to Zen Estate?
Yes, I have, ma.
You know that very big house at the center?
Yes, I do. I do.
Robert built a house in each of his estates in the name of his grandchildren. That house is for Marcus, IG's son. Those are the documents.
Wow.
That's not all. He also instructed that house be given to you to stay, pending the time Marcus will be old enough, at which point you'll be able to make decision on what to do with it. Femi,
what?
That house is yours.
Hey. Thank you so much, ma. Thank you. Ma, you mean that gigantic house belongs to me?
It is. Congratulations.
Ah, thank you very much, ma. Thank you, ma. But, ma, I hope there won't be complications later.
Complications? No complications. I'm certain you already got his lawyer to settle that. Femi,
ma?
You are part of Robert Alake's dynasty now. I just wish live a little longer.
Mommy.
Just a little longer.
this woman. May the Lord comfort you. The Lord understands all this. May he give you the fortitude to bear this. This woman. This woman. Let's go and meet the other people.
Our lives are in your hands now. Chief is gone. I trust that you have better plans for us. Because,
you stay awake?
I can't sleep.
Why? What's the problem?
Is this how someone dies? Life is just fickle.
Is this about Chief Alake? He lived a little long and wealthy, didn't he?
What about salvation?
He wasn't saved?
I'm not sure he was.
Well, if he wasn't, that would be too bad.
Remember what I told you on the day we settled our big fight?
That was a long time ago. You said many things.
I told you that if not for the love of God and his faithfulness, both of us would have been consumed by our unrighteousness. It is by grace that we are saved.
I remember now. We really had it rough, didn't we? From adultery to domestic violence. We really came to a tilt.
Thank God we didn't fall over the cliff.
Yeah, thank God.
I've been up imagining what would have happened if we had died before we made up.
I can just imagine. Thank God we were saved before we self-destructed.
Thank God.
You have an holiday tomorrow. Please catch some sleep.
You see, many people are not as fortunate as we are. Yeah. Time has outlasted some. This thing is transient and irreversible. There is no better time to make a right decision than now.
Yes.
Patricia must know this.
Now I know where this is going. Let's trash it out with her in the morning, okay?
Okay.
Please, catch some sleep.
All right.
Thank you. God, I don't even know what to think.
To think that we were celebrating having a house in Zen Estate.
And now we have one of the biggest houses there. Hey, God is great. That man really rated you.
And I don't even know why. Come on, he was supposed to even dislike me.
Dislike you? Because of what happened? Come on, you fed me. It is God's grace, and we should be thankful for it.
I am.
And we should also be thankful for Prophet God's power. That man's prophecy carries so much potency.
See you talking as if you've known him all your life.
Whether I got to know him today or 20 years ago, it does not matter.
Well, I think we should thank God for Pastor Wright as well. The man has been immense in our lives.
Yes, thank God for him and his wife. Let me see the documents.
Femi, what is it?
The house is in Marcos's name.
Yeah, our son.
No, your son with Ijoma.
Yes, my son with Ijoma. But he's also more or less a son to you. Is that a problem? Okay, no problem. Hello, IJ.
Femi.
How are you?
I'm holding on.
I sent you a message yesterday. Once again, please accept my condolences on Daddy's passing.
Thank you for the message. I appreciate it. We'll all be all right.
Amen. How is Marcos doing?
Your son is fine. He doesn't even know what's going on. Considering the events of the last few weeks, I wish I am as oblivious of the world as he is.
This is adulthood.
Hmm.
I just wanted to check on you. I was at the house yesterday.
Mom told me. Thank you very much. Congratulations on the new house, by the way. Dad must have really liked you.
I guess he did.
Zen is in your hands now. Please make it work.
With God on my side, it will. Take care of yourself.
Take care.
Okay. Hello.
Hello, Femi. Thanks for the message.
It's nothing. How are you holding up?
Well, I am glad I got to spend hours talking on the phone with him on his last day here. Congrats on the house. You really caught Daddy's eye.
Why does everybody keep saying that?
Keep saying what?
Never mind.
That's my line. Anyway, I'm calling because I need your help.
What for?
The funeral arrangement. I knew next to nothing about such an event.
I'm not expert either.
But at least you're at home and can help me close deals with specific vendors.
Okay. Send me what you need.
Thank you very much.
Come on. It's the least I can do.
You're part of the family too.
Take care.
You too.
Family, I really should have ministered to him.
Hello?
Hello, Prophet. It is me, Femi Gomez. We met on the flight from UK a few weeks ago.
Oh, Brother Femi. How are you doing today?
I wish I was better, sir.
What's the problem?
There is something I would like to discuss with you. I've really messed up.
Messed up? What did you do?
My boss was a highly influential and wealthy figure in this country. By providence,
I gained a unique access to him.
The last few weeks, he has been sick, and I had an urging in my heart to minister the word of God to him. But I just couldn't bring myself to do it.
Why?
Honestly, I don't know.
Was that your first time?
Of witnessing? No. I just kept postponing it. Now the man is dead.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. Who is this your boss?
Chief Robert Alake.
Oh, I knew him. It is well, my brother. Indeed, you have really missed an opportunity to save an influential soul for the kingdom.
I know. The guilt I feel has robbed me of sleep for the past few days.
Don't do that to yourself. Indeed, you have not done well. But you don't have to beat up yourself over this matter.
The man lived long enough to hear about the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ through various channels. If he chose not to give his life to Jesus Christ, then
your witnessing to him would have changed nothing. As for you, there are still a billion numbers of souls to win for Christ. Just don't make the same mistake twice.
You mean God won't place an account of his blood on my head, as in Ezekiel chapter 3?
My brother, you are speaking about verse 18 of that chapter. If you go back up to verse 7,
the Lord said, the house of Israel will not hearken unto thee, for they will not hearken unto me.
For all the house of Israel are impudent and hard-hearted.
God knows all these people.
Don't beat yourself over what God knows that
will be a futile mission in the house of Alaki.
Come on.
The house of Alaki might have been won over to Christ through me.
But you could not go ahead with it.
What God needs from you now is a rededication.
Ask for forgiveness and atone for your sin.
This kind of thing has never happened to me before.
When did you become saved?
About 15 years ago, sir.
Then you ought to know what I am talking about.
This atonement, what do I need to do aside from praying for forgiveness and tarrying in the Lord's presence?
Exodus 30 verse 16. And the Lord said,
and thou shalt take the atonement money of the children of Israel,
and shall appoint it for the service of the tabernacle of the congregation, that it may be a memorial unto the children of Israel before the Lord,
to make an atonement for your souls.
The first step is to sow a seed to the progress of the work of God. I'm not asking you to give me the money, but God is merciful. And he will restore you if you obey.
I think I understand you, sir. Is that all?
That's all. Come on. Working with God isn't so hard now.
I'm relieved to hear that.
Relax. God is not a wicked judge. Just do as I have asked you to, and you'll be fine.
Thank you so much. My wife and I are very grateful for all you do for us.
Come on, if I don't do it, who will? The prophetic office is what God called me into since when my mother conceived me. I will show you more revelations as time goes on.
All right, sir. Thank you very much, sir. That's all that has been troubling my mind.
Please, make sure you sleep well from tonight. Don't add sickness to morning. I will check on you from time to time.
Thank you very much, sir. Goodbye, sir.
Bye.
I thought the call would never end.
Ministry calls.
I know. Are you giving me the money or not?
Nene, I've told you to give me some time.
You said that last month.
But I need a little more time. I'm a man of God. I won't lie to you.
But you didn't mention this when I willingly decided to help you with your carnal desires.
I have been performing wifely duties without getting any benefits.
Come on, Nene. Don't be like that. For your information, if you don't do it, another person would have done it. A man can only live by himself for a long time.
Then why did you relocate your wife and children to the UK?
If they are still around, will you be where you are now? My prophetic inclination requires some solitude and space. A clergyman's need are the stores of mysteries. Don't bother try to search through it.
I will pretend like I understand what you just said.
That's the idea. I don't need you to think. Just do my business, okay?
Give me the money, and I will do everything you bid me to do.
Just a little time.
Okay. I am leaving now. I'll see you in the evening.
Good.
All right.
Where are you coming from at this time of the night?
Mommy, I just...
Sit down. We need to talk.
Mommy, can I just...
Don't make me say it one more time. Sit. When did you start receiving letters from boys?
Letters? Mommy, if it's about that one that you saw that day, it's one naughty boy in my class that has been disturbing me. And I told him I don't do nonsense. I told him so.
I see. So, you have not been receiving letters from boys?
I haven't. True to God.
Anyway, maybe you can tell me what's... This, and this are.
Mommy, how did you get all this? Have you been going through my things?
And what if I go through your things? You are my daughter. Why don't you tell me about these letters before you decided to start gallivanting around town with those good-for-nothing boys?
Mommy, Wale's father is the commissioner for health, so I don't think he's good for nothing.
Oh, shut up! That a father is noble does not mean the son is. Okay, tell me, what do you people do when you hang out? Or you think I don't know that you are always there when you are not here?
When we hang out, we study, we praise, and we worship.
Hey, Patricia! Do you know what the Bible says about liars in Proverbs chapter 12, verse 22? Lying lips are abomination unto the Lord. But those who deal faithfully are his delights. Hey, when did you start lying this much, Patricia Irebami? Where did you learn how to lie? No response, Abby. Anyway, having received negative reports about your academic performance and your lack of interest in spiritual things, you are grounded till further notice. And I mean it this time. Every night, I'll be having Bible study sessions with you and your sister. I'll be giving you assignments which you must submit. Disobey my orders, and I will get your father involved.
But Mom, is it that serious?
You think? We are talking about your destiny here, and you are toying with it. It is deeper than deep. My labor over you will not be in vain in Jesus' name. See you tomorrow by 8 p.m. for the first session. Good night.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Let me help you with this one. Ah, what is it?
What?
This one that you are looking at me like that. I know that look.
Can't I look at my wife again? I thank God I'm married to you.
What's happening? Where did that come from?
From the depth of my heart. I'm just grateful, that's it.
Aww. Okay. Oh. I'm also glad I'm married to you.
So, babe, what's your plan for today?
Well, you know, I have an online exam to prepare for. And in the afternoon, I'll go and pick two for me from school. That's all.
That's all?
That's all.
Fantastic.
Ah. What is it?
Yeah, you know, as the husband of this beautiful woman,
mm-hmm.
I'm taking you ladies out tonight.
Where to now?
You have to wait and see. It's a special treat.
Brother Femi is up to something.
And Sister Precious has to wait till evening to know what it is.
Now, what for you?
You know me now. Yeah. Hey, babe, did I even mention that I spoke with Prophet Gospower yesterday?
No, you did not.
Oh, I'm sorry. It must have slipped my mind. You know, since I heard about Chief's death, I felt so bad that I didn't witness to him. So I had to go confide in Prophet Gospower. And then, you know, I was quite pleased and relieved after our conversation.
What did he say?
He asked me not to beat up myself over the matter that gosses my heart. And then he said that I should seek for atonement by praying and sowing a seed.
Oh, that's not something strange to us now.
Exactly why I said I'm relieved. The sowing part wasn't that clear to me. But I didn't push it because we already had it in our plans. Yeah. And then besides, prophets since the times of Old Testament have always used unusual method.
Yeah. Well, the work of God needs a lot of support.
Yes. I felt I let God down. But then the Bible says that if we confess our sins, that God is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us of all our unrighteousness. So.
I'm glad you are relieved. Because I was beginning to get worried.
Babe.
Yes?
I'm wondering if it's still necessary to inform Pastor Wright.
It's your choice to make, you feel me? Thank God for Pastor Wright, but Christianity seems less difficult with Prophet Gospower.
I think you have a point. Yeah. Okay.
So, how far with burial preparations?
You know Uche now. Uche won't let me be. I'm doing my own bit. Yeah.
Okay.
All I can say is that plans are progressing.
So you are all set to go?
Babe, I'm all set to go, thanks to you.
Right. Have a fabulous day at work.
Yeah, thank you, baby. And see you tonight for our special trip.
Definitely.
All right, that's it, babe. Yeah. Bye-bye.
The blizzard, a wind of change, a strategy of the devil to destabilize your peace. Never get stuck in the blizzard of fun. It takes away your joy and happiness. The blizzard. Blizzard, the blizzard.
the blizzard. Blizzard, the blizzard.
Look who has finally decided to join us.
Patricia, what is wrong with you this morning? Why are you lethargic? You were acting funny during the devotion too.
She probably woke up on the wrong side of the bed.
Why are you carrying a long face? Are you okay?
Good morning, Dad. Good morning, Mom.
Good morning to you. I hope you know you're already running late. We need to leave now.
But I've not eaten.
Pack your food. You have to take your breakfast in school.
What's wrong with you? You have been moody since last night.
Why are you acting like you care?
Of course I care. Talk to me. What's the problem?
I don't know. Tell me.
Tell you what?
Mama was in our room last night with letters from Wally and other guys. Why did you tell her where I kept it?
I had to, because I am concerned about you. You always hang around with them till late in the night. I was worried about you.
So snitching on me is the solution, right?
I did not snitch on you. I only made Mommy aware of what was happening.
Oh, I see. I think I know what your problem is. You are jealous. The fact that no one is going for your holier than thou self eating you up. Let's go, sis. Jealousy is ungodly.
Come on, Pat. What you are saying is very far away from the truth.
I don't care. All I need you to do for me is just mind your business, Naira's fault.
Your business is my business, Pat. I'm doing what Jesus would do.
Jesus, I know, but you, I don't even know.
Jesus loves you, Pat. Change your ways.
Petra. Thank God you are my sister. If not, you would have known what I would have done to you.
A packet from IJ. Okay, send him in. Okay. All right. Okay. Oh, okay. Hello, Ide.
Hello, Femi.
I just got a package now and it's addressed from you.
Yes.
I don't understand.
It's the Ashoebi for that burial.
Ashoebi? Isn't that supposed to be worn by just family members?
And what are you? You are the father of one of his grandchildren, remember?
Ah.
What?
I'm not comfortable with this. Do I have to wait?
What sort of question is that?
How many years is it?
Enough to sow whatever you need.
So you did not even consider my wife?
My bird, I consider the father of my son, to be honest.
IJ, I thank you for putting me in good consideration, but I think I would have to pass. I can't wear the ashore be meant for chief immediate family members.
And where will you be when they're asking for my son's father?
Is your husband not coming with you?
Are you seriously telling me that you'd allow another man take your place in your son's life?
You know I would never allow that to happen.
I see. Wait, are you mocking me by asking about my husband?
How?
Are you really not aware?
Of what?
Of the fact that I'm no longer with Gabriel. Hmm? Now it's quiet. Tell me you didn't know and I'll call you a liar.
In truth, I'm aware. And I'm really sorry. The last few weeks must have been really tough for you.
Tough is an understatement, but I'm self-sufficient.
All right. I can't wear this outfit without my wife. I'm sorry.
Shoot yourself. But don't blame me for feeling unrecognized and out of place when the relatives of your son's grandfather come around. See you at the burial.
I have an idea. Wisdom is profitable to direct.
The blizzard, a wind of change, a strategy of the devil to destabilize your peace. Never get stuck in the blizzard of fun. It takes away your joy and happiness. The blizzard. Takes away your joy.